And continuing adventures of audio component features that nobody can seem to figure out, we have another button or switch found on many cassette decks, which is labeled using inscrutable terminology and where turning it on and off seems to have no discernible effect. The MPX filter. It is a feature only found on tape recorders with Dolby noise reduction, so you won't find it on those with an alternative non-Dolby form of noise reduction, such as NRC, or DNR, or those which lack noise reduction entirely. However, even among cassette recorders which do have Dolby noise reduction, you won't see an MPX filter button or switch on integrated stereo systems, nor will you find an MPX filter button or switch on inexpensive entry-level cassette decks. Even many mid-range to high-end cassette decks don't have a button or switch for the MPX filter either. For example, this Pioneer CTF-615 from the 1970s doesn't have it, nor does this JVC TDR-431 from the 1980s, or this Philips FC-931 from the 1990s, and none of these were cheap cassette decks in their day. Among the decks which do have a button or switch for it, it's often combined with the Dolby noise reduction switch, such as on this Sankyo STD-2000 from the 1970s. It gives us choices of both Dolby and MPX off, Dolby on with the MPX off, and Dolby on and MPX on. While on other decks, such as this Denon DRM-24HX from the 1980s, and this Nakamichi cassette deck 2 from the 90s, it's given its own button, which can be turned on and off independently of the Dolby noise reduction circuit. The first secret I have to reveal is that all tape recorders with Dolby noise reduction have, or at least should have, an MPX filter. All that having a button or switch for it does is give you manual control over the filter. Otherwise, the filter is engaged automatically whenever you make a recording with Dolby noise reduction, or on some decks, whenever you make any recording, regardless if you're using Dolby noise reduction or not. But that still doesn't answer the question of, what is MPX and why would you want to filter it out anyway? The first thing you should do when you encounter a feature that you don't know the purpose of is to check what the owner's manual has to say about it. I like in this one where they wrote, Sankyo has incorporated every conceivable feature to assure long-lasting, state-of-the-art performance. And here it says Dolbyized, I didn't know that was a word, tape recording. To record FM stereo broadcasts using the Dolby system, set the Dolby NR switch to Dolby On, MPX On. To record other sources with the Dolby system, set to Dolby On, MPX Off. And here's the manual for the Denon DRM24HX. It says the MPX filter switch should be used to prevent interference with the Dolby NR circuit when making Dolby NR encoded recordings of FM stereo programs. When making Dolby NR encoded recordings from any program source other than FM stereo, leave this switch in the off position. And finally, here's the manual for the Nakamichi cassette deck 2. It says recording FM broadcasts with Dolby NR. Set the MPX filter switch to on. This cuts off the 19 kHz multiplex carrier signal, which could interfere with proper Dolby NR operation. That 19 kHz carrier is also known as a pilot tone, because it illuminates the pilot light on your receiver, indicating that the station you're tuned to is broadcasting in stereo.
As stereophonic FM programs are tuned on a Zenith instrument, a red pilot light comes on automatically. The pilot light always tells you when FM stereo is on the air.
To visualize the effect of the MPX filter, I connected this little realistic TM150 tuner to this Pioneer cassette deck, and I'll put it into recording monitor mode. I love that loud clunk it makes. And there's a reason why I'm not using one of my higher quality FM tuners, which I'll explain later. Now it's connected to the audio input of my computer, which is running a spectrum analyzer program. This is the audio spectrum from 0 to 22,000 Hertz. And right here at 19 kilohertz, you can see this big spike. That's the FM multiplex pilot tone. But when I engage Dolby noise reduction on this deck, you'll see it drops way down. It doesn't eliminate it entirely, but it reduces it by about 35 dB, so that it's now below the level of the audio. So on this deck and many others, even though there is not a dedicated switch for the MPX filter, it engages the MPX filter as soon as you switch on Dolby noise reduction. To demonstrate the effect of the MPX filter, I set up an FCC-approved low-power FM transmitter tuned to an unoccupied frequency, and I have a CD player as its program source. I'm receiving that signal on my CC Radio Plus. I have its stereo line output connected to my Denon cassette deck, and this is a three-head deck, so we can monitor the recording it's making on the tape as we're making the recording. We don't need to stop, rewind, and play it to hear how it sounds exactly on the tape. For my first test, I'll just be transmitting dead air, so complete silence on an FM stereo radio signal. And I'll be recording it on a standard Type 1 tape. I'll start out with no Dolby noise reduction and no MPX filter. And since this is a Type 1 tape, you'll hear plenty of tape hiss. Then I'll engage the Dolby noise reduction without the MPX filter, and you'll hear that the hiss reduces a little bit, but not nearly as much as it should. Then I'll engage the MPX filter, and you hear that the hiss quiets way down. That's because the Dolby noise reduction system is designed to cancel itself out if it detects that the audio you're recording has enough high-frequency content to drown out the tape hiss, and that 19 kilohertz tone from the FM radio signal is fooling it into thinking that is the case. So it responds by canceling itself out, and that's why if you record an FM stereo signal without the MPX filter, you get much less hiss reduction than you should. Of course, in the real world, radio stations don't transmit extended periods of dead air, or at least they shouldn't. And if you're recording a heavily processed commercial radio station whose modulation level is consistently high enough to drown out the tape hiss, you probably won't notice the difference that the MPX filter makes. But in that case, you might as well not use Dolby noise reduction at all. But if you're recording a station whose program material has greater dynamic range, such as classical music or spoken word content, then you will notice the difference that the filter makes.
Bass so deep and powerful it shakes your brain and rocks the neighborhood. Roller coaster swings that soar from a whisper to a scream, then back to a whisper. It's all part of the amazing dynamic range of CDs. And if you want to get it all down on tape, you've got to be serious about the tape you use. Bass so deep and powerful it shakes your brain and rocks the neighborhood. Roller coaster swings that soar from a whisper to a scream, then back to a whisper. It's all part of the amazing dynamic range of CDs. And if you want to get it all down on tape, you've got to be serious about the tape you use.
It's important to note that this has nothing to do with the hiss that you get when receiving a weak FM signal in stereo. The MPX filter will do nothing to improve that. It'll just help prevent it from getting even worse when you record it to tape. It's also unrelated to the beat cut button you'll find on many boomboxes and integrated stereo systems. I've already covered that topic in another video. Also, the MPX filter only affects recording. Even if you turn on the switch for it, It does not engage the filter during playback. So now you know what can happen if you don't use the MPX filter when you should. It won't necessarily sound bad, but the Dolby noise reduction system won't be able to work as effectively. But you may ask, what about the opposite? What would happen if we do use the MPX filter when it's not necessary, when we're not recording FM stereo? Well, the answer is, and this is the next big secret of this video, probably nothing. That's why so many decks like this JVC don't let you turn it off. They just use the MPX filter automatically whenever you record using Dolby, regardless if you're recording FM stereo or not. However, if you've been around audiophiles for any length of time, you know they pride themselves in being able to hear things that other people can't hear. And they probably could insist that they can hear that 19 kHz filter, and they would say that would be negatively impacting the audio quality by filtering out that frequency when it's not necessary. So in that case, to please audiophiles, that's when you have the button to turn it off. I'll demonstrate that by playing the same sample from the CD player twice, just passing through the recording monitor of the tape deck, not actually recording it to tape. The first time I'll play without the MPX filter, then I'll play it again with the MPX filter and see if you can hear any difference. I doubt you will. And another secret is that even when you are recording FM stereo, as long as you're using a good quality tuner, the MPX filter on your cassette deck is usually not necessary because the tuner has one built in. As the glossary I found in the back of a manual for a Sony cassette deck explains, tuners are usually equipped with the multiplex filter, but if you get poor results when recording FM broadcasts with the Dolby NR system, your tuner may not have a filter, or the filter may not be working. In this case, press the MPX filter button on the tape deck. So now you may wonder, what would happen if your tuner has its own MPX filter, and you turn on the one on your cassette deck, or you're using a cassette deck that doesn't let you turn off the MPX filter? The answer is, again, probably nothing. Because 19 kHz is so high that most adult humans can't hear it anyway. So whether you're filtering it out once or filtering it out twice, you're not going to hear the difference. So hopefully this video has demystified the MPX filter. I know recording from FM radio isn't of much relevance anymore, unless you're a big fan of Wait, Wait, Don't Tell Me. But in case you ever have a cassette deck with an MPX filter button or switch on it, now you know what its purpose is. And if you don't have that button or switch on your cassette deck, then you have nothing to worry about, and watching this entire video has been a waste.